The life of a commercial airliner is generally specified based on the stresses the structure receives over time. Aircraft structures are manufactured with stressed skinned philosophy, where the aircraft skin, along with frames, beams, and ribs, is a load carrier. So, in today's video, let's examine how long these structures last and the factors that come into play. Multiple sections of the airframe are held together with rivets and fasteners. Since most commercial aircraft fly at high altitudes, pressurizing the cabin at human survivable levels becomes necessary. Pressurization cycles add to the stresses the aircraft structure endures during flight. A typical day in the life of a narrow-body jet, such as the Airbus A320, calls for 5 to 6 flight missions. Such frequency of structural stresses limits will have an impact on the lifespan of the aircraft. The airliner's operational life is specified through the fail-safe and safe-life philosophies of manufacturing. The fail-safe philosophy ensures that a complete failure to the structure does not occur even if part of it fails. For example, frequent pressure cycles incur high stresses on the airframe. As a result, the structure is fatigued and prone to cracks and breakage. If a specific section of the airframe is ruptured, it'll not cause the entire structure to fail. The stressed skin philosophy prevents the fuselage from breaking and causing a complete failure. The safe life philosophy allows manufacturers to establish lowered inspection programs for systems that cannot be covered through a fail-safe design. For example, the aircraft landing gears cannot be covered under fail-safe operations despite the stresses endured upon each landing. Thus, a safe life strategy is implemented by adjusting inspection requirements to identify anomalies long before failure. An aircraft landing gear can survive 30,000 routine landings before the need for inspection for abnormalities. However, a safe life strategy imposes a detailed stress inspection at 10,000 cycles, preventing the chance of undetected fatigued parts. The long-term upkeep of the aircraft we cover on this channel isn't cheap, and making any investment like this right now can be worrying. We're no investment gurus, but we all know trying to make our money work for us is a necessity in today's economy. But even the companies that shaped our daily lives are losing trillions of dollars in market cap. As a result, investors are moving towards real assets, whose value is less likely to fluctuate when stocks do. In fact, the ultra-rich have nearly doubled their spending this year on one real asset in particular – fine art. It sounds odd, but it's just supply and demand. They aren't exactly making any more Picassos, but the demand has remained steady for decades. In fact, contemporary art has shown price appreciation over 13% when inflation is at its current levels. According to the MW All Art Index, when compared to the S&P, the index of the top 500 companies on the stock market, contemporary art has historically outpaced it by 131% over the last 26 years. I had no idea art could be such a financial asset. But it's why we're excited to be partnering with Masterworks. This platform qualifies their paintings with the SEC, turning legendary art into an investment for a fraction of the full price. Masterworks has had a total of 9 exits, with 5 of them this year alone. And their last 3 exits delivered 13.9%, 17.8%, and 21.5% net returns. And with these results, demand is growing, so there is a waitlist. But you can skip it just by clicking the link in the description. But to answer the question of today's video, how long should commercial airframes actually last? Aircraft manufacturers maintain a balance between the hard limits of safe life parts and failure modes of the fail-safe designed systems. Short-range narrow-body jets are typically intended for 50,000 flight cycles. With this in mind, an aircraft that has an average of 5 flight cycles per day will probably see 27 years of operation, plus the downtime for maintenance. Long-range wide-body airliners with conventional fuselages, such as the Boeing 747, are designed for approximately 30,000 flight cycles. With an average of just 1.2 cycles per day, such aircraft can last over four decades. The life limit of newer composite-driven wide-body airframes is much higher. According to Boeing, the designed lifespan of a Boeing 787 Dreamliner is 44,000 flight cycles. While it is not uncommon for airliners to have over three decades of operational life, unusual routines and various events age the aircraft prematurely. Airplanes that regularly fly very short distances are prone to frequent stresses on the airframe and wings. For example, aircraft operating short island hops for Hawaiian Airlines are expected to age much more quickly than the same aircraft type flying different missions in other parts of the world. Economic factors also force some carriers to move their aircraft into premature retirement, as in the case of the Airbus A380 and a few airlines. New and more efficient entrants to the market also have the effect of pushing less economical aircraft out well before retirement age. Operators frequently renew their fleets to have aircraft with lower fuel burn and lower operating costs. Did you know the approximate lifespan of an aircraft before watching this video? Let us know by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.